Authentication is a developer's worst nightmare. It's usually complex, takes a lot of time to get set up, and can be incredibly stressful, worrying about things like JWTs, cookies, short-term, long-term, where to store this data, all those kinds of things. But it doesn't have to be that way. So this video is going to show you how you can set up authentication with Clerk in minutes and provide things like nice login pages, user profile buttons, the ability to manage your account, change your password, and even integrate social logins out of the box.
So here we are in a plain terminal, and we've done absolutely zero code so far. So let's begin by setting up a new Next.js application, although this could be any kind of React application you wanted, but we'll start with Next.js. So let's just go ahead and cd into my development environment, and let's do npx create next app, and we'll call this one Clerk in minutes. Now, while that is creating our application, we can go ahead and open up Chrome window here and go to clerk.dev. When you sign up for account for Clerk, you'll go to this dashboard here and you'll be able to add your application for the first time. So we're going to click that and we're going to say Clerk in minutes. And we'll do password, email, Google, and we'll also add Twitter. Hit finish. And our application is essentially done at this point. What we need to do is at least grab this API key. Go ahead and copy that down. And now we can go back to our application. We can cd into Clerk in minutes. And we can do yarn add at clerk slash next.js to install the next.js package that allows us to do the work. Now that's installed, we can go ahead and open up our code profile here. So now we have VS Code, we can start setting up our application. The first thing we need to do is go to pages and go to our app.js. We need to create a provider wrapper that will wrap our application as needed. So we can do that by doing import Clerk provider from at clerk slash next.js and hit save. And all we need to do is wrap this component in that. So we can go ahead and change this to return and say inside of here, Clerk provider, and then copy this, drop it in here. So now our application is actually ready to be used. We need one more step here. So inside your application, you need to not .env, .local, or .env, and you're going to do next underscore public underscore clerk front end underscore API equals, and that API key that you had copied from the dashboard. So if you've forgotten already, it's this one right here. Go ahead and copy that and paste it in and hit save. So now our application has Clerk provider wrapped around it. So now we need to do is to add in the ability to test whether or not we're signed in, signed out, and then offer a way to sign in if they are signed out, and a way for them to manage their account slash log out as well. Now in other auth providers, you'll probably have to do a lot of work to get this done, but with Clerk, you just need to use our built-in components to handle this. So we're going to use signed in and then signed out. And then if they're signed in, so if they are successfully signed in, we'll show them this components. And what we'll do on top of that is do user button. And that's just a way to open the user profiles and also log out of our application. And then in our signed out, what we'll do is we'll send them to sign in. And then we just need to import all of these. So signed in, signed out, and sign in, and user button. Hit save, and our application is ready to launch. So we can do yarn dev here and let that load. And now we can launch localhost. And as you can see, here we are, we're being asked to sign in. So let's go ahead and click it in with Google, and we'll sign in with my Google account here. And we've now been redirected back to this page. Now, if I zoom in a bit more, 125, and click this button here, I can now manage or sign out my account. So in here, I can connect another account. So I could connect my Twitter account if I so wished, or I could add another email address that's not my primary email address. I can set my password, and I can see under here what active devices are available.
So that might have felt like the world's shortest tutorial, but it just shows you how easy authentication should be. Of course, now you can add authorization, roles, memberships, and things like that, and we'll probably do more future videos. If you are interested in SaaS building, go ahead and click this link right here. It'll take you to a playlist of my new SaaS building project, 2 devs, 1 editor, and until the next one, see ya.